On July 25, 1534, a band of sailors straddled ashore on a new land. Under the command of navigator Jacques Cartier, a 61-man crew had spent nearly 3 weeks crossing the Atlantic Ocean from their native France. King Francis I wanted some of the wealth that Spain had found in Mexico and South America. He had hired Cartier to search for gold and other precious metal that he believed could be found in North America as well. Cartier and his crew explored the coast of North America and sailed into what is now the Gulf of St. Lawrence. They came to land on Gaspé Peninsula. There Cartier erected a large wooden cross on the shore and claimed the land for France. He had not found gold, but he had gained his country a foothold in the New World. France would remain for more than 20 years, and its claims would grow to cover nearly all of eastern half of North America. However, for many years after Cartier claimed land in what would come to be known as New France, there were no colonists to live in it. In 1541, France tried to establish a colony along the St. Lawrence River, but it was a failure. Within a year, all the colonists had either died or returned to France. For the next 60 years, France limited its interest in the region to fishing expeditions off the Atlantic Ocean. This changed in the early 1600s. The French had become interested in the fur trade. Europeans had overhunted most animals in Europe, and fur pelts were valuable. Fox and mink fur was used to trim the clothing of kings and wealthy nobles. Beaver fur was used to make popular hats. Fur pelts earned good prices for traders. France decided to set up fur trading posts in North America to trade with the American Indians. In 1604, French explorer Pierre Dubois, Sieur de Monts, founded a settlement in the territory of Acadia in order to establish a monopoly on the fur trade in the region. It was the first permanent French settlement in North America. Acadia included the present-day Canadian province of Nova Scotia, New Brunswick, and Prince Edward Island, as well as part of state of Maine. Acadia occupied territory that was also claimed by England. This led to frequent unrest, and Acadia changed hands many times over the next 150 years.